the skin, it is the envelope for this body. Now, if I have to touch the eyes, I have touched the eyes or I have touched the skin? Oh, I have touched the skin first, and then only I can say that I have touched the eyes. So, which means it is running all over the body. It is all omnipresent. As far as this body is concerned, skin is omnipresent. It is present everywhere. Now, for example, if you touch my finger, you have touched my finger or you have touched my body? Oh, you have touched my body. You touch my cheeks. You have touched my cheeks, you have touched my body. Oh, you have touched my body. So any part of my body, when you touch, it's not that you have touched only the toe. Through the toe, you have touched my body. Because skin runs all over. Likewise, divinity in this existence, it is all over. It is omnipresent. When I do something good, when I do a massage to my finger, oh, I feel good about it. When you give a massage to my hair, a head, I feel good about it. You press my legs, oh, it makes me feel good. So whatever you do to any part of the body, it makes me feel good because that is a part of me. So likewise, this entire existence, it created that plant, and that plant is part of this existence. It created that animal, it created those reptiles, and it also created that human, who are all nothing but the various parts of this existence. Like as I have the various parts of this human body, likewise, they all are the various parts of this existence. In doing good to one particular part of the human body, I've done good to my entire body. Similarly, in doing good to one of the existence of the creation, I've done good to the creation, to the creator. I want some particular job to be done, and I get to understand that you're one of those persons who can help me get a particular job done, which is very, very important. For example, some registration work has to be over and I need your assistance for it. And I come to you. And before I come to you, I park my car, I come to your street, and there some children, they are playing cricket. And as they're playing cricket, the ball they hit, it hits my car. So the person, the boy who hit that ball, I call him and I tell him, why are you doing this? And from there, you're watching all that I've done. And then I come and ask you, this is the help I need. And I was referred by so-and-so and I was told that you'll be able to help me. Immediately you will tell me, sorry, I won't be able to do this help for you. Why? Because the boy whom I, you know, hurt happens to be his son. If I hurt the son, the father is not going to be happy about it. Instead, when the boy hit and the ball came and hit my car, and I tell that boy, oh, wonderful, yeah, you seems to be good at batting. Come on, you bowl. Let me also try. Let me also bat. And then you pat, you know, really encourage the boy, not knowing who the boy is. And then you go to the same person and you tell him, this is the favor I want and I've been referred by so-and-so. Can you please help me? Oh, he'll be able to help you because you have just now done a lot of good to the boy by encouraging him. And he felt good about it. When some unknown person encourages the child also feels good in terms of what they are doing. So when I take care of the child, it is automatically in doing good to the child, I've already done a lot more good to the father. So the best way to please my father is to please the children of the father. The best way I can, you know, be in the good books of my creator is by taking care of the creations, because everything is part of him. Every part is part of this body. If every part can be a part of this body, every creation is also part of the creator. So in doing good to the creation, I do good. I make my father happy about it. And skin is telling, I'm omnipresent. Existence is telling, I'm omnipresent. Wherever you touch, you've touched me.